Okay, so when we look at the area where the saddle sits, so here's a picture of a front shot where you see the rib cage, you see the shoulder blade, upper arm, and when the horse, this is the sternum, you're looking from the front, when the horse lifts the rib cage, you can see the angle becomes pointier. So what could happen is that the horse lifts the rib cage, and by lifting the rib cage, the angle where the saddle sits, well, it's getting pointier. Horses sometimes, for many reasons, one could be, of course, the saddle fit, one could be this alignment anywhere else in the body. Sometimes they drop the rib cage and then the horse is in pain. So neutral, the horses lift up, and my job as a rider to really bring up the horse's rib cage for many, many, many reasons. So when the rib cage is lifting, as I said, the angle of the saddle won't match anymore. So let's talk about quick as a reminder. Tree width, we're looking from D-ring to D-ring. That can be individually adjusted. Let me show you this slide here. This is the angle. Sorry, this is the tree width. So red simulates all the same angle. Okay, so a very well-built saddle, a saddle what is in quotation mark, a fittable saddle, has to be adjusted in the tree width. It's a top part, D-ring to D-ring, independently from the tree angle. Here, you see the dotted yellow line. The tree width is the same, but here's green, there's red, and there's blue. You can see they're all different angles. The tree angle is so important, so we don't have all the pressure on the top, because as I showed you a couple slides ago, when the ribcage comes up, the angle changes. Now, when I take a measurement of the tree angle with the digital angle finder or this old tool here, very, very interesting to see how we could have different saddles with different tree width. From thumb to thumb would be approximately the tree width, and here from green pen to green pen. So that simulates that you could have the same angle but different tree width. Now, when you take that angle finder or this Sprenger and you put that tool right behind the shoulder, and you see all these different ribs here, and you go further and further and further back, the angle gets wider and wider and wider. Okay, again, one more time, the angle, it's this here, not the distance from thumb to thumb or green cap to green cap. So the further we go back on the horse, the wider the ribcage spring. So if you have a saddle, what is set at a certain angle, then the horse comes up, okay, and now the angle doesn't match anymore. Okay, so when the angle doesn't match anymore, the angle of the tree is now too wide. What will happen is the pull on the front of the saddle, or the pressure from the front of the saddle, most of the time where the D-ring is, has first contact, and the bottom of the tree point does not sit on it anymore. Kind of like this here, see? The other reason you can say, oh, my horse doesn't get lift rib cage anymore. Maybe the trapezius section. This is the trapezius section here, okay? The cross section where the spinalis rhomboides trapezius is. And the saddle doesn't sit here. Either the saddle slides back, it slides back until this matches again, until we have contact, like on this middle one, on the longissimus dorsi. So before the saddle slips back, it most of the time starts with the saddle pad. Sometimes the horse has very slippery coat, and you have washed that in the saddle pad in ultra light washing material. And with the slippery coat and with that super duper washing detergent you use, the pad will slide and the horse has not lifted the rib cage, like shown here, or has not got width more through the trapezius muscle, and your pad still slides back. or you have a pad but doesn't form fit the withers. There's many, many saddle pads. If we look the horse from the side, you know, the withers there is, it's really high. And many, like if I look at this here, for example, this picture, look how high this withers is and comes down. I see many pads with absolutely straight. The binding will press down on the withers and then slides down. So that's another reason why saddle pads slide down, because they're not form fitting the shape of the top. So we got the shape, we got the detergent, and of course, most likely when the horse changes the rib cage, it lifts, comes up, and the tree doesn't follow correctly, or the wither muscle gets bigger, the angle doesn't fit anymore. First the saddle pad slides, then the saddle.